5 People You Meet in Heaven by Mitch, Albom. This is a book podcast about the book. After reading this book, I asked myself, what should I read now? Because this book makes me feel that the next book I'll be reading will be a little less. So this was by far one of the most or one of the best fiction stories I had read this year. And I mean it when I say that because I only read few fiction books this year. I turned to reading nonfiction because the fiction books that I stumbled upon did not satisfy me. They were either cliche stories or too marketing or selling oriented. Well, of course, writers need to feed themselves, but I think many modern stories are highlighting popularity over quality. So without any more crappy rants, let's start to talk about the concept of the book, The 5 People You Meet in Heaven. At the first look of the title, I had expectations that this one is going to be a spiritual or life after death story. Well, my expectations were somehow not wrong. But on the spiritual part, it's literally not that spiritual. It had its unique way of setting morals in the story, and it's more focused on morality than spirituality. The author was a great storyteller. I was reading this with my baby rabbit, and my baby rabbit literally just slept all throughout the 2 chapters while I was reading it in a low voice. Of course, baby rabbits sleep a lot, but that's not the point. The point is, it is a light read and with beautiful descriptive words. The story is about Eddie, a war veteran who fought and got captured in the Philippines. I think this was the era of the Philippine-American War, when Americans wanted to colonize the Philippines, but eventually it ended in peace and the Phil-American friendship emerged. That was around the year 1945. So although the book was a fiction one, it has a reference in or with real-time happenings and real war stories. After the war, Eddie was trapped in a meaningless life of fixing rides at a seaside amusement park. As the park had changed over the years, so too has Eddie changed, from an optimistic youth to an embittered old-aged man. Then on his 83rd birthday, Eddie dies in a tragic accident, trying to save a little girl from a falling cart. With his final breath, he feels 2 small hands in his, and then nothing. He awakens in the afterlife thereafter, where he learns that heaven is not a lush garden of Eden, but a place where your earthly life is explained to you by 5 people who were in it. These people may have been loved ones or distant strangers, yet each of them changed your path forever. One by one, Eddie's 5 people illuminate the unseen connections of his earthly life. As the story builds to its stunning conclusion, Eddie desperately seeks redemption in the still unknown last act of his life. Was he able to save the girl, or did the girl die too? The story ranges from Eddie's boyhood to his war experiences, then his marriage, and then his remaining life. This is where every reader could reflect, because at wherever you are in this stage of life, you can relate to the book or in Eddie's experiences. I also had found best quotes from this book about family and parents. It was well written and I had saved it in my notes. So it says here, quote, "Parents rarely let go of their children So children let go of them. They move on, they move away. The moments that used to define them, a mother's approval, a father's nod, are covered by moments of their own accomplishments. It is not until much later, as the skin sags and the heart weakens, that children understand their stories and all their accomplishments sit atop the stories of their mothers and fathers, stones upon stones beneath the waters of their lives. Unquote. See, it's a beautiful quote, or at least I hope I did not ruin it by reading, but a one-liner quote that also got stuck in my head is that, quote unquote, all parents damage their children. So I will not be telling about the story any further because I might spoil it for those who haven't read the book, but I believe that this one is already a bestseller, and Mitch Albom is a popular writer, so many have read this already. I still think, after finishing the book, if I would get to meet the 5 people in heaven. Now, I wonder why it has to be limited to 5. But in my case, I don't think I had greatly impacted 5 people. For them, for those 5 people to wait for me and explain things why I had existed or why things happened the way it should be. But, you know, if ever there would be 5 people that I had or I have to meet in heaven, well, I'll thank them for waiting and explaining, but I pretty much know that they could feel obliged by doing that. Or I'll tell them that, I bet you had just no choice because God had sent you to talk these things through. So in the 5 people you meet in heaven, Mitch Albom gives us an astoundingly original story about afterlife and the meaning of our lives here on earth. He also had written a book entitled Tuesdays with Maury, but I have no idea what that is. Now, maybe next year I will read again a book from the same author, and maybe we could get to interview him in this podcast. So thank you for joining me with this short but sweet podcast. It would make my day if you hit subscribe or favorite or follow Book Academy Podcast wherever we are streaming. Thank you for listening.